Friend, if you're headed out by the Tukata, Lord Varrison is paying actual credits for bone marrow samples. Varrison's doing some sort of experiment for Lord Renning. The less details we know, the better, I'm sure.
Oh. more bone marrow samples. Lord Renning will be pleased. You may go.
A fresh young acolyte come to view my experiments. Good. I trust the sight of a messy operating table doesn't disturb you?
The path to power is not for the faint-hearted.
You remind me of myself at your age. This used to be a Tukata, the hound-like creatures infesting Korriban's tombs. On the surface, nothing special. But I alone can see this creature is an expression of pure dark side energy, aggression made manifest.
Amazing. How did you learn that?
The Force told me so. It speaks to me. The Force is alive. It expresses its will in the physical world. This Tukata was one such form.
Are we another of these forms?
Sith are the highest manifestation of the Force's will. I've dissected hundreds of Tukata, forging a direct connection to the dark side. Each beast I examine advances me toward perfect unity. I now stand at a new frontier, but find myself thwarted. My most perfect specimen, a Tukata mutant, escaped to the tombs before I could analyze it.
Your work is too important to fail, my lord.
Indeed. Perhaps the Force has brought you to me for a reason. You acolytes delve those tombs on your trials. You could hunt that Tukata for me and retrieve its perfect brain. My apprentice, Melora, saw which tomb the mutant beast fled into. Find out what she knows, assist me, and you will be rewarded.
I'll speak with Melora and do whatever is necessary, my lord.
You found a great calling in my service. I trust you appreciate that.
Sergeant Garrus, turns out the rumors were true. Some of the sentries we lost down here aren't dead. They lost their minds, just like the acolytes. Doesn't mean we're gonna have any easier a time getting the research supplies back, though. The crates are secured with multi-locks. If we're going to open these things without frying the contents, we need to get all the sentries' code cylinders back. I don't think negotiation is an option. The men aren't keen to take down their old comrades, but we'll do what we can. Once we have the code cylinders, we'll crack open the supply crates and get back. Tavon out.
Thank you.
now.
seeking Lord Renning's lost pet, are you? Don't waste your time. That fool's research is pointless.
Not a very loyal apprentice, are you?
He's my master in title only. He has nothing to teach anyone about the dark side of the Force. Renning deludes the Dark Council into believing he's advancing Sith knowledge. The truth is, he wastes the Empire's time and resources dissecting mindless animals. But if his experiments were discredited, he would be banished, and I would be rewarded.
Tell the Dark Council he's insane. I'm sure they'll listen.
Don't be naive. The Dark Council would never believe the word of an apprentice over her master. Look, just a minor alteration to the mutant Tukata's brain would allow me to reveal my master as a fraud. Bring me the brain before delivering it to Lord Renning, and I'll make it worth your while.
I'm sure there's some way we could work this out.
Perfect. Then we have an agreement. The mutant Tukata escaped to the tomb of Mark of Ragnos. It's much larger than the others, so it's easy to spot. Return to me with the brain before you see Lord Renning, and I'll take care of the rest.
At your service, my lord. Travel route is confirmed.
Yes, can I help you with something?
Hold on. Are those the research supplies we were after? I'd given up on them days ago.
You've no idea how much I appreciate this. Some of these chemicals take months to manufacture. Not much use to you, but vital to us.
Thank you.
You're welcome to use some of our equipment as compensation. I'll make sure to mention you to the commander.
What can I get for you? Come back anytime.
Displaying all authorized destinations. Travel route is confirmed.
Thank you.
Have you recovered the mutant Tukata brain yet? I'm eager to conclude the business we discussed.
It's right here. Have it.
Excellent. This chemical will make it appear as though Renning is falsifying his research. There. All that remains is for me to whisper the right words in the wrong ears. I'm transferring credits to your account now. Give Renning the brain and collect his reward, too. You've made out quite well.
If I'm connected with this, you're the first to die.
Save your tiresome threats. I'll take care of everything. We shouldn't be seen speaking again. Lord Renning might suspect us. Give him the brain.
You have the brain at last. Excellent work. I trust it wasn't too much trouble.
The creature was hardly a match for my power.
Of course. After all, you're an expression of the dark side's will, too. I must continue my research at once. Great discoveries await. Take a reward and go.
It was a pleasure.
Yes, yes, you may stop talking now. Goodbye.
I told you we shouldn't be seen talking to each other. You have your reward. Go away.
Thank you. peace is a lie. There is only passion. Perhaps calm is necessary. Perhaps a little blood will satiate you. Just open, damn it!
At your service, my lord. Travel route is confirmed.
You must be one of the slave acolytes. Pretty easy to see why Overseer Harkon was horrified. Regardless, Lord Zash has made it clear that all new acolytes must learn martial skills as well as face their trials. Though why anyone thinks you can be taught is beyond me.
I assume someone a bit more learned will be instructing me.
Someone with a bit less pull, you mean? Not for all the credits in the world. You will find the instructors in the Academy's archive. Hurry, and try not to embarrass your betters.
What do you want? I'm training slaves to feed the beasts, and I don't have time to chat.
I'm here for a special meal. You know the kind.
You've been talking to Seyrun, haven't you? That creature was close to me when I was an acolyte. It helped me survive my trials. It traveled places I couldn't, told me everything it heard and saw. It had been living off vermin before I came along. I figured out a way to make it healthier, stronger. Seyrun's special meals.
It seems too pitiful to be useful.
I thought the same thing at first. I didn't realize. Seyrun never knew exactly what I fed it. Its meals weren't just beast fodder. Seyrun ate the corpses of the Academy's failures, the bones and blood of dead acolytes. Feeding on their energy after death, it grew exponentially more powerful with every meal, and became strong in the dark side.
You fed the corpses of dead students to that thing?
The sludge we feed to the slaves and the Tukata wouldn't have sated Seyrun. And bodies pile up quickly here. It was an easy way to dispose of them. When I saw how twisted Seyrun was becoming, I sent it away. It was becoming hungrier all the time, and I feared it would attack the living. Destroying it seemed impossible. It could heal any injury it suffered. I hoped it would find a new home somewhere, but it seems we must act more decisively.
If it bleeds, I can kill it.
No, that is... Seyrun may not be strong enough to kill acolytes on its own. But it can't be slain. Its regenerative abilities draw on the power of the Force. Together, we must poison Seyrun. Before I sent Seyrun away, I developed a powerful toxin, but I didn't have the heart to use it. It won't kill the creature, but it should strip it of its power.
Seyrun helped you. It adored you. How can you be so ungrateful?
If I thought I could keep that thing, I would. I tried, but Seyrun isn't what it used to be. Poisoning it would be merciful. If we do this, Seyrun won't survive much longer. It will hide as best it can and slowly starve. But the alternative is to let it become a living horror.
Seyrun needs to become strong. It needs its food.
Seyrun's not loyal to the Sith. Not to me, and certainly not loyal to you. But I have a degree of loyalty to the creature. If this is what you insist on doing, I'll give you what Seyrun wants.
Perhaps the creature will prove useful again. It's an interesting experiment, if nothing else.
Perhaps. This should be what you need. Feed it to Seyrun, and the creature will have the strength it desires. Let's hope we're not making a mistake.
You better not be wasting my time, slave. You better have the holocron. A fake. Or stolen from the library, probably. I'll deal with you later. Now, I believe it's time for another demonstration. Gurr, step forward.
Yes, Overseer.
Fon, kill him.
With pleasure, Overseer.
Let Gurr be an example to you. Fon destroyed him easily, like he will destroy all of you. Are there any other objections?
No, Overseer. No objections.
Now the rest of you know the next trial. Go. You, slave, stay here. Now, slave, you think yourself pretty clever getting that holocron, don't you?
I really am the best.
You are lucky Lord Zash finds you useful. Now for your trial. The last, darkest secrets of Tulak Horde are buried in his tomb. Lord Zash wants this text. But the final resting place of the dead lord is not easily trespassed. You will not be the first to die there.
Is there a reason you keep sending me into the tombs?
Lord Zash's research is her own business. And no one else's. You're not fit to know. Any other stupid questions?
Don't you just hate how the sand on Korriban gets in everything?
You are begging for death, slave. Do not come back here until you've gotten the text from Tulak Horde's tomb. Out of my sight, slave!
So, yet another acolyte stands in the shadow of our academy. You must consider yourself privileged. Tell me, you who would be Sith, have you seen much of our civilization so far? Have you been awed by this world's power and glory?
Indeed, I have. Korriban is most inspiring, my lord.
You find it so? Then you should understand something. Korriban was wrought by the true-blooded Sith millennia ago. Our ancestors, a crimson race of conquerors, raised the statues around us. Over the eons, however, our people mingled with slaves. Now the red markings of true Sith are rare, and the purity of this planet is in question.
You're mingling with a former slave right now.
Is that so? This is a sad day, but you may yet be useful. True purity and strength are carried in the blood. I worry that our blood is being diluted over generations. In the Emperor's name, I have come to learn whether the Academy's overseers are Sith or not. You will be my instrument.
It would be an honor.
It is a glorious opportunity. I possess an ancient device, a holocron, that can read and record bloodlines. It will pulse with life near the overseers. Allow the holocron to fulfill its purpose. Stand near the overseers as it attunes to their blood purity. Then return here, and I will learn the truth.
I have need of you, young one. Whatever errand your master sent you on can wait until we are through.
As you say.
I am Inquisitor Urinth, and I represent the intelligence operations of the Sith. We are currently holding an important Jedi prisoner, a spy who attempted to reach this academy. We have plans for him. Upon capture, we found the Jedi's mind simple to manipulate. We fed him false memories through a combination of drugs and sorcery. Soon he will return to his Jedi commanders and report the lies we fed him. He will know nothing of what we've done. All that remains is to stage his escape.
Look no further. I am your Sith.
Good. I'm pleased that you appreciate our project. You are young enough, new enough, to be a plausible traitor. You will go to the Jedi, talk to him, do as he asks. Earn his trust. When that is done, set him free. Do whatever is necessary to get him out of prison. We will ensure that he reaches his ship and returns safely to his Jedi friends.
Consider it done.
You will find the Jedi Quarian Dorjus in the jail cells. He is still confused and should not be overly difficult to convince.
Last, a worthy disciple. Be gone.
There is no emotion. There is peace. There is no ignorance. There is knowledge. The Jedi Code will guide me.
I take it you're the Jedi who was captured.
I'm Quarian Dorjus. I'm a Jedi. Even here. Even on Korriban. Why do you care? Why are you here?
I want the Jedi to see you broken and despair.
Is that my fate? To be a symbol of your triumph? Better than staying here, I suppose. You're here to help me. Why am I talking in circles? What's wrong with me?
Am I supposed to care?
You're right. I apologize. There is no passion. There is serenity. There is no... There is no emotion. There is peace. There is no ignorance. There is knowledge. The Jedi Code will guide me.
I take it you're the Jedi who was captured.
I'm Corian Dorjus. I'm a Jedi. Even here. Even on Korriban. Why do you care? Why are you here?
I want the Jedi to see you broken and despair.
Is that my fate? To be a symbol of your triumph? Better than staying here, I suppose. You're here to help me. Why am I talking in circles? What's wrong with me?
Am I supposed to care?
You're right. I apologize. There's no passion. There's serenity. There's no chaos. There's harmony. The Jedi Code will guide me. I can focus. If you want to help me escape, I'll need my belongings, my lightsaber, my comlink. Before I was captured, the Sith chased me into the tomb of Tulak Horde. I hid my belongings inside an urn to lighten my load. That is where you'll need to go.
come here, child? Do you intend to explore the Academy? To know the world that gave birth to the Sith? You should linger here a while. I am Overseer Raggate, a keeper of the old ways. I sense you have potential, and I can help you if you like.
Everyone in the Academy seems to sense my potential.
But you have not yet come into your own. You have power and strength in the Force, but you must be tested beyond the trials your masters have set for you. I administer the rite of blood and bone, a ritual performed beyond this doorway. It is a rite acolytes have participated in for 10,000 years.
I'm sure you were young and pretty back then.
Yes, I am shriveled. I am infirm. Yet, I survive. More than most Sith can say. Learn from my example. In the chambers past the gateway, there is a colony of Shyrax, my leather-winged, razor-taloned children and their brood. They guard a mountain of skulls, an altar to the Academy's failures. You must reach the bones before proceeding.
I'm dying of suspense, really.
Then I will continue. You must claim a skull from the mountain and return to the antechamber. Soak the skull in the blood pool and come to me. Once bone has turned red, I will look and see your nature written in crimson stains. And possibly a glimpse of your future.
I'll admit that does sound intriguing.
To complete the rite is to accept one's death, to steal one's own mortality and drown it in the fluid of life. That is the symbolic purpose. But it is also a trial of power, as are all Sith trials, a trial to test strength and to grant it. I will await you here. If you die, I will forget you.
I'm sure you'll find it satisfactory. Thank you. Now grow stronger and feast on the meat of acolytes. Many more will come to these caves.
Bien, Sultanite, Kelsnadi, Namakampiet, the Hermanai Margumak. Katra, the rest of the Dagdok.
Step forward. I assume you've completed my task. I will take the holocron now. It is time we judge the purity of your overseer's blood. Time we know how much of the ancients survive in their veins.
What does it matter? The ancient Sith are dead.
It matters because the ancient Sith are the source of our power. They are everything we are. The holocron, it glows white. So little Sith blood in all of the Academy. And only one of the Overseers wears the red marks. This is shameful. I will bring this to the attention of the Dark Council. Measures must be taken if the true Sith are to survive.
You must be terrified that the true Sith might become extinct.
I fear for the Sith as a whole. And I would honor the ancestors who gave me strength. You have served well. It is too late for me to alter your training, but in the future, perhaps acolytes will kneel at the feet of the pure-blooded.
come closer, Acolyte. The wind outside has torn my ears to tatters, and my eyes grow strained and bloody in the dark. I've studied this tomb for years, slept on its stones, and dreamed of its depths. Now, I need assistance to solve its final mystery.
Really? So are you mad or just obsessed?
Why should my sanity matter to you? This tomb is the final resting place of Tulak Horde. The tomb's maze was built to his precise specifications. But he built his maze to hold more than just his body. He built it to secure his greatest creation, his terrible machine, the Red Engine.
Keep going. What Red Engine?
The machine was his life's work. A perfect puzzle that hid all his secrets. It was a vault and a library all at once. The scholars in the Academy, they say the Red Engine was never completed. They say it never functioned. But I know how it works, and I know how to fuel it.
You're talking about a machine that's been here for centuries. If it still worked, the Sith would know by now.
A Sith's power comes from passion, not from decades of study and research. This is the only reason I've learned what they will not. Listen now. Anyone can activate the Red Engine, but unless it receives its sacrifice, it will only sputter and die. The machine needs blood and hatred to become fully operational. If a Sith could slay the tomb's beast in its presence, their deaths would be its fuel. Find the machine within the tomb. Work its mechanisms. And when at last it reveals Tulak Horde's secrets, I beg of you, bring me its scripture. Bring me the knowledge I have dreamed of.
Blasted mining droids. We're tougher than I thought. I'm not going to make it, but I hope whoever is watching this will honor me. Escaped slaves, stole weapons from the Academy, fled into this tomb. They've reprogrammed the mining droids. Without those droids, the slaves won't survive. Tried to take them down myself. Didn't work out. Destroy enough rogue droids, and the slaves will die. Teach them not to cross the Sith.
medical attention. Be well.
I know you. We talked before. My head's clearer now, Sith. It's all here. The comlink, my lightsaber, everything I hid. You're going through with it. With all this, once the guard's chain shifts, I think I can slip out of the academy. But what about you? Will you be okay?
Korriban is my home, Jedi Filth. I fear nothing here.
I should have remembered that. I apologize for my concern. I still don't understand why you're doing this, but I thank you.
If everything's settled, I'll be leaving.
As you say, Sith. Thank you again. I'm sorry the Empire took you in instead of the Jedi. If things had been different, maybe you could have been part of the Order.
So the Jedi is preparing his escape. You did well. Not perfectly, but I have confidence the operation will succeed. Our business is concluded. I will make note of your assistance in my report.
I don't need your praise.
No, I imagine you don't. Take these tokens as payment for your service, and know that no Jedi can threaten Korriban. Now go.
Ah, approach. I've heard rumors of your exploits in the tombs. You follow in the footsteps of failed apprentices. Ones sent to slay renegades and crack the shells of armored droids. You fared better.
I'm just here for the exercise.
Nonetheless, you have done the Academy a service. The mining droids not only protected the slaves who subverted their program, threatened to damage the tombs of the ancients. That would have been unforgivable. And for succeeding where others died, you will be rewarded.
At last, a worthy disciple. Begone.